Great Pyrenees have been around for centuries. They are likely descendants of guardian dogs that were in Asia Minor around 10,000 B.C. Around the year 3000 B.C., nomadic shepherds went to the Pyrenees Mountains and brought their guarding dogs with them. This was likely the beginning of the Great Pyrenees breed. Great Pyrenees are very large white dogs. Since they were bred to watch over flocks of sheep, they can be quite protective of their family members. When strangers aren't around, these dogs can be very affectionate and playful with the people they love. They have a calm and patient temperament and can make a great family dog. Because of their large size, it is important to make sure these dogs have plenty of space to run and play. Great Pyrenees are a large breed dog. Males are a little larger than females in this breed. They are typically between 27 and 32 inches tall and weigh between 100 and 120 pounds or more. Females generally stand between 25 and 29 inches tall and weigh between 85 and 100 pounds or more. 3-month-old puppies weigh between 29 and 40 pounds. When they are 6 months old, puppies will typically weigh between 54 and 74 pounds. These dogs will be fully grown when they are 19 months old. Before you bring home one of these dogs, there are a few common health issues that impact this breed you should be aware of. While not all of them will be affected by these issues, knowing about them can help you prepare to provide the best level of care for your dog. As a large dog breed, Great Pyrenees can suffer from gastric torsion, more commonly known as bloat. The stomach of a dog suffering from bloat becomes distended and then twists. This prevents the dog from being able to get rid of the excess air in their stomach by burping or vomiting. Bloat can be life-threatening, and you should rush your dog to the vet right away if they exhibit any signs of it. Feeding smaller meals throughout the day and limiting your dog's exercise after eating can help prevent bloat. Another potential health issue for these dogs is hip dysplasia. This is a genetic condition where a dog's thigh bone doesn't fit properly into the joint at the hip. It causes the two bones to rub against one another, which can be quite painful and can cause a dog to limp. Since this is an inherited condition, you should check on the health history of the parents before buying a Great Pyrenees from a breeder. These dogs can also suffer from Addison's disease. Also called hypoadrenocorticism, this condition occurs when a dog's adrenal gland isn't able to make enough adrenal hormones. Adrenal hormones control the level of potassium and salt in the body. Sign of this condition may include loss of appetite, vomiting, lethargy, or, in some cases, heart arrhythmia. Vets can treat Addison's disease with corticosteroids or fludrocortisone acetate. Great Pyrenees have a very affectionate and patient personality. They are also very calm and intelligent. These traits make the Great Pyrenees a great family dog. They can exhibit playful behaviors, making them a good companion for a child. These dogs will do best with young children when they are socialized from an early age and have opportunities to interact with children. Because they were bred to be mountain dogs to watch over sheep, Great Pyrenees do bark quite a bit. They will bark loudly to alert their owners if a stranger is nearby. Great Pyrenees can also be destructive if left alone. It is important to make sure your dog is crate trained. As you prepare to take care of your Great Pyrenees, there are a few things you will want to keep in mind. These dogs have unique health concerns, training needs, nutritional needs, temperament, and more, which will make caring for this dog breed different from caring for other breeds. When choosing food for your dog, always select high-quality options from trusted manufacturers. Since Great Pyrenees are susceptible for bloat, you will want to avoid feeding them a large meal and then having them exercise a lot. Rather, Choose to feed your dog multiple smaller meals each day and give your dog some time to digest before giving them exercise. This will help reduce the chance of them suffering from bloat. Compared to other large breeds of dogs, Great Pyrenees typically eat less food. However, they need to get enough omega-3 and omega-6, so be sure to look for foods that are high in these healthy fats. Great Pyrenees puppies have a smaller stomach than their adult counterparts. It will be important to feed them even more frequently throughout the day. Each meal should be relatively small. As the puppies get older, you can slowly reduce the number of times you feed them and increase the amount of food they receive with each meal. Great Pyrenees have long and thick white fur. They will shed a lot of fur from their undercoat during the spring. Brushing your dog with a slicker brush or a pin brush once a week, or even more frequently, can help limit the amount of hair that they'll shed. In addition to regular brushing, it will also be important to brush your dog's teeth a few times a week to reduce the buildup to plaque and tartar. Their nails should also be trimmed regularly to keep them from getting too long. If their nails become too long, it can become painful for them to walk. Great Pyrenees can be a little challenging to train. They were bred to be very independent and don't always immediately follow commands. Great Pyrenees will do best with experienced dog owners who know how to train a dog. You can also consider signing your dog up for an obedience training class. Positive reinforcement training methods work best for Great Pyrenees. If Great Pyrenees don't get properly trained, they can become uncontrollable. A 100-plus-pound dog that does not know how to behave can be a real problem. A Great Pyrenees is not an overly active dog, but they will still need moderate exercise. They were bred to be mountain dogs to protect livestock. While they will patrol the area they are protecting, they do not exert a great deal of energy, unless there is a threat they need to fend off. Daily walks to time to run around in a fenced-in backyard can meet the exercise requirements for this breed. Great Pyrenees also do well participating in obedience trials or cart-pulling activities. If you are thinking of bringing a Great Pyrenees puppy home, you should first confirm that your home and lifestyle will be conducive with this dog breed's needs. Great Pyrenees will grow to be very large dogs, so they will need a large space where they'll be able to run around. They do well in farms, ranches, or homes with a large fenced-in yard. Shortly after bringing your puppy home, you should begin to crate train him or her. Crate training can help Great Pyrenees find a quiet place to rest and will also help with your potty training efforts. Great Pyrenees can be destructive if left to roam around alone, so you'll want to get them used to going in their crate. Great Pyrenees are an excellent dog breed for a family with young children. These dogs are affectionate, patient, and playful. Especially when they are exposed to children from a young age, a Great Pyrenees can make an excellent companion and playmate for a child. As with other dog breeds, it is always important to closely supervise children when they are around a Great Pyrenees. This will avoid accidental injury. Toddlers and babies should be very closely supervised due to the large size of a Great Pyrenees. Great Pyrenees may act like a guardian for a child. They can become quite protective. You will want to make sure your dog is properly trained and socialized to prevent them from acting too aggressively towards strangers. While your puppy may be quite small, depending on how early you adopt him, be ready for him to grow quickly. Adult dogs can reach 120 pounds. Your puppy will also need plenty of exercise, so be sure to take him for walks, play with him, or let him out in a fenced-in yard to play.